Alors, je vais commencer par vous présenter rapidement nos invités.
All our guests up here.
Je vais commencer de droite à gauche.
From the right, Denis Fred, and then go to the left.
Producteur du film, qui
Denis
accompagne
Fred,
les
producer,
films de Jean-Pierre et Luc Dardenne depuis déjà plusieurs années, depuis l'Office.
Now. Since
Alors,
the Sun,
l'occasion de réviser Le Fils, L'Enfant, Les Silences
the
de Lorna, Le Gamin au vélo,
the silence,
Deux jours et
une nuit, bike,
La Fille inconnue,
days, one
et cette
night,
année, donc,
the
Jeune
unknown girl,
Ahmed.
And this year, young Ahmed.
Denis est producteur de bien d'autres films aussi, Pierre Scholler notamment, et il ne fait pas que les frères, il fait aussi les sœurs, les sœurs Coulin. À côté de lui, Othman Moumen, qui joue le rôle de
l'imam dans le film.
Pas évident à reconnaître, d'ailleurs.
Not easy to recognize, in fact, at the table.
Une autre débutante dans le cinéma
de
Dardenne, Victoria
Bluck,
À côté d'elle, Jean-Pierre
Dardenne.
Entre Luc et Jean-Pierre,
du film, we have the hero in the film, the protagonist, Ahmed, Idir Ben-Adi.
Bravo.
Congratulations.
Ensuite, donc, Luc. Myriam Akedjou, qui est une habituée du cinéma de Jean-Pierre et Luc,
in Jean-Pierre and Luc's films,
avec notamment Le Gamin au vélo, Deux jours et une nuit, La Fille inconnue,
bike, two days, one night,
Olivier Bonneau,
the
qu'on avait découvert
Olivier Bonneau, who
dans le rôle
we discovered
de l'étudiant en médecine,
as the medical student in The Unknown Girl,
l'assistante d'Adèle Haenel, débutante aussi pour les frères, mais qu'on a vu notamment dans
The Brothers films, but we
Alors,
saw her in Joachim Lafosse's films.
Il y a des questions, il y a déjà une question ici.
I think there are questions already.
Présentée.
Elena Ibrahimova de l'Ouzbékistan.
Elena from Uzbekistan.
D'abord, merci beaucoup.
Thank you very much.
J'étais vraiment touchée.
I was deeply moved when I watched the film yesterday. I even cried.
Génial.
It was wonderful.
Je pense mes félicitations.
Congratulations. It was a resounding success.
Le problème qui vous montrait que la société ne peut rien faire pour changer.
That society doesn't appear to be able to do anything to change young Ahmed.
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez dire par ça?
I don't know what you wanted to mean by that. What were you trying to say?
Ça servait à rien.
Everything that they tried failed.
Juste quand il est tombé, juste à ce moment-là, il est changé.
Until he falls and he's truly changed. So what can we do to help these young people today?
C'est une grande question.
That's a really big issue.
Et c'est vrai que
It's true
on peut dire que
that one can say
les éducateurs,
that educators,
la mère,
the mother,
le professeur de l'école de devoirs,
the
beaucoup
teacher,
de gens essayent et n'y arrivent pas.
A lot of people try their
Parce
best, but they don't succeed.
On veut faire le bien.
When you're a fanatic, you think you're doing what is right, and you think you're doing what is right for others as well. And you can't sort of reverse that line of thinking. That's why these people are scary, because they're convinced that they're right.
On a trouvé cette fin où on le met
so
face
we found
à sa mort,
this end,
où il appelle sa mère,
when Ahmed is faced with death, he calls
Allah,
his mother. He doesn't call Allah or the imam, he
Et
calls his mother.
C'est ça qu'on a trouvé.
And that's
Parce
what we found. Because
si vous voulez,
we couldn't
à mettre un personnage secondaire en rapport avec lui pour le faire changer.
Get any
Donc,
of the other characters to intervene and change him.
De la réalité,
If you talk about reality
jeunes,
now, what should we do with these young people? That's a real issue. It's a true problem.
Tout le travail
I would
des
like to say that the work done by educators,
de référence,
the reference educator, which is
c'est
the part portrayed by Olivier, dans le film. This is work which isn't finished in the film.
Mais je pense qu'il y a aussi moyen de...
I think there is...
Le film se termine, si
Some
vous
way
voulez,
of doing
parce
something.
Qu'il n'a
the
pas
film comes to an end.
Son travail, puisque le garçon
but
s'en
we
fout.
Don't see the remainder of their work, because the boy runs away. But I think a lot can be done,
ça,
particularly
cas,
amongst the younger children. The older ones, I'm not sure.
Comme enseignement de tous
but
les gens
I think the, what we have learned from all the people who work in this kind of education, the educators, the psychologists, the advisors, the religious and philosophical advisors, they all said to us that something can be done, but it takes time and it's very difficult. It is possible.
Jean-Pierre.
Jean-Pierre.
La réponse était complète, monsieur.
I think a very comprehensive answer was just given.
Bonjour, messieurs, dames. Je m'appelle
Good morning. Marion Goetz. I represent
Television sur l'internet.
An internet TV channel
Television.
Called Supremus Television.
Et ma question est.
My question.
Surtout aux réalisateurs des films.
Is for the directors of the film.
Jean-Pierre Dardin et Monsieur.
Jean-Pierre et Luc Dardenne.
Bien, votre nom.
And I'm sorry if I mispronounce your name.
Selon vous, what extent, votre film contribution à la paix entre
your film contribute
la société occidentale
between Western society
du Moyen-Orient
and Middle Eastern society?
Oh.
Merci bien.
Oui. Oula.
Well.
Il faut. Il faut rester humble quand on fait du
cinéma. One has to be very humble when you make a film.
Le film n'est pas un tribunal.
The film is not a courthouse.
Le film n'est pas un acte d'accusation.
The film is not
on essaie de voir comment
fact an indictment. What we try to do is to see.
C'était notre pari au début.
Well, this was our wager at the outset. We wanted to see
ramener
how we
ce jeune Ahmed vers la vie.
Bring Ahmed back to life in a way.
Et
we tried several things.
Le film raconte quand même
the film,
deux mains qui se serrent à la fin.
As
donc,
you see
c'est
at the
film
end,
de paix qu'on a fait.
There are two hands
pas,
that
un film de paix ne veut pas dire un film de
shake.
De naïveté imbécile.
Not a stupidly naive film. It's
parce
a film of peace because we believe
la vie au prix de beaucoup de je ne sais pas quoi. Mais la vie est toujours la plus forte.
Is always stronger. Life always prevails.
Tous les totalitarismes,
totalitarianism,
fanaticism, toujours vaincus par la vie.
Have always been overcome by life.
Sometimes it's difficult.
Sometimes they tend to come back, but they've always lost out in the end.
Et j'ajouterais que on n'a pas voulu notre personnage, on a essayé de l'aimer vraiment.
We tried to love our character.
C'est pour ça qu'on a pris aussi
and
quelqu'un
that's why
de plus jeune.
We also took someone who's
parce que quand on a un personnage,
when you have
si
a character,
pas,
if you don't love the character, you make
roman.
A bad film or a bad novel. So we tried to love our character and we tried to consider
lui,
that what he was experiencing
heureux,
was a misfortune for him. Even if he looks happy,
imam,
even if he loves his imam, if he's,
part,
even if he's totally taken in by the imam, but we kept saying to ourselves, well, a pre-adolescent can't say that kind of thing. Think that kind of thing can't be so harsh with the teacher who helped him to learn to read and write. It's simply not possible. And the fact that it isn't possible, at least this is what we hope that the spectator starts thinking as well and starts thinking that indoctrination is something very deep and you have to go very far in terms of a misfortune to enable him to rediscover life.
And
the time comes when he is faced with his own death. You don't know what that is at that age. You don't know what death is. It's when you get older that you start to realize that. So that's what we were thinking. We didn't find anything else, if you like.
Hi, I'm Shireen Sharif from BBC Arabic.
Okay. Yeah?
Sorry, I'm not speaking French, but...
In French.
Okay. Now?
Oui.
I'm Shireen Sharif from BBC Arabic. First, I want to congratulate you on the topic. It's a very important issue, especially for Western countries right now. And Edir, you were very good, really, in acting the character. My question, first for Luke or Jane, it's about the preparation of this film. To understand the mentality of a teenager living in a Western country with this culture and how he developed this, let's say, obsession with the ideas of the conservative or whatever we call it. What did you do to prepare for this and to understand it first of all. Especially the film, amazing in my point of view, but only in the end, I would say I expected different end, because from my knowledge, I'm from Middle East, I understand how it is. People in this situation goes happily to die. If they believe in these ideas, they don't give up, even if they are facing death. Maybe I'm wrong, but this is what I have been seeing in my life. So you maybe don't agree with the end. I'm not sure why you choose it this way, but maybe you wanted to promote the idea of the peace. But I'm more concerned about how did you try to understand this. And for Idir, what was the challenging part for you to prepare for this character to do? And that's it. Thank you.
Idir,
vous êtes préparé au personnage. Oui, j'ai compris, je crois. Ah, mais c'est parce que je suis pas sûr que ça marchait. Si.
Je me suis pas vraiment préparé, j'ai plus juste appris
le texte. Prepare myself. I learned my lines, and then it sort of happened all by itself, thanks to the support from the Dardenne brothers.
Est-ce que vous pouvez nous est-ce que vous vous souvenez quand vous avez passé l'audition pour avoir le rôle?
Auditioned for the part.
Comment ça s'est passé? Qu'est-ce qu'ils vous ont dit en premier?
How did things work? What did they say to you? What scenes did you have to play?
Ce qu'ils m'ont dit en premier, c'est.
What they said to me. First of all, we talked about soccer, we talked about football.
Les scènes qu'on m'a demandé de jouer, c'est
and I was asked to play
après où je the me suis scene avec ma mère.
Of the day after I quarrel with my mother.
J'allais prier.
And I go off to pray. She wanted to hug me, but I didn't want her to.
Il était très fort parce que la mère était interprétée par mon frère ou par moi.
The mother was played by my brother or by myself, so it wasn't easy.
Jean-Pierre et Luc, vous avez.
Jean-Pierre et Luc.
In French, sorry, but in English it's more, too difficult for me about that. La fin.
At the end.
Comme j'ai essayé de le dire.
As I was trying to say.
Vous ne pouvez pas, selon nous, le faire avec.
According to us.
À l'aide d'un autre personnage. Et vous avez raison, je crois, votre expérience le dit, la nôtre character. Aussi, même si elle est
right.
Plus vivresque que la vôtre, par rapport aux gens qui nous ont conseillés, nos informateurs,
les psychiatres, les psychoanalystes, les educateurs, les religion teachers, les imams, despite what they said,
ne désarme pas.
Faced with death, a fanatic doesn't give up, doesn't step down. That's why we decided to choose a very young actor, a very young character, with the idea that he could change, he could
be different.
And faced with death, he calls his mother.
Avec laquelle il allait encore attaquer.
The weapon with which he was going to attack Mrs. Inès, he was going to use that to call her, to save her.
Et en même temps, on a construit de manière à ce que
put things together in such a way that when Mrs. Inès opens the door and says, I'm going to call an ambulance,
he
holds her back as though there's something more important than that. He wants to say he's sorry and wants to shake her hand, after which the ambulance can be called. So we wanted to show the scene of reconciliation, of peace. We wanted to save our character. Of course, it's a fiction. It's not the truth. It's just a real fiction. But what we were hoping
à la réalité, il fait,
this
et donne la dimension de la profondeur de l'endoctrinement, du fanatisme, parce qu'il faut aller jusqu'à
clouer
au sol face à sa mort
pour changer, death, c'est quand même terrible. On the ground,
de devoir en arriver là.
It's terrible to have to go to that length to then be saved. And that's what saves him for us. But it may surprise you, I can understand that. We had a lot of other possible ends. We wrote a lot of other ends, which we then discarded.
Si c'était pour copier la réalité,
if the idea was to just copy reality, we weren't actually interested.
Ce que vous dites est vrai, hein?
Because what you say
dans
is
réalité,
very true. In reality, in real life, that's what happens.
Nous, on s'est dit, si,
we thought, therefore,
si nous on fait un film,
that if we make a film,
cette affaire de fanatisme.
Which talks about fanaticism.
Il faut qu'on essaie de donner un autre éclairage.
Shed some new light on things. We can't just copy real life. Let's try and see whether the character can be saved or not. That's what interested us.
Ça ne nous intéressait pas de dire, et voilà, les fanatiques, même jusqu'à
saying, well, fanatics, au dernier moment,
even comme vous dites, hein,
faced with death, as you
la mort
say,
ne les fait pas reculer.
Well, they're not scared. They're not going to be held back by the idea. On the contrary.
But because we chose a
child, he doesn't like us saying he's a child.
Un jeune garçon.
He's a young man, really.
C'est quelqu'un qui est...
He's someone...
Oui, il y a encore beaucoup de possibilités.
Who has endless possibilities still. He's not yet totally closed.
En voyant le film, bon,
yesterday,
c'est un peu
watching the film,
un moment particulier pour nous,
it was a special moment for us to see the film in this big room. It was the first public screening. We felt a bit tense, but I said to Luke,
il me disait la même chose,
and he said the same thing to me.
Je n'avais pas soupçonné à quel point,
I didn't suspect
malgré
qu'on le sachait, although we actually knew it, I didn't realize to what an extent he was really a child.
Que je pensais.
Even more than what we thought.
Oui, comme personnage.
As a character.
Il y a, et je pense que c'est parce qu'on veut. Je pense que c'est en tant que spectateur, on veut peut-être le sauver.
As a spectator,
aussi.
You probably think that he can be saved. It's not he who's talking. It's someone speaking in his stead. He's been possessed. It's the imam with his business about his cousin.
Mais ça, c'est y dire ça. Qui amène ça au personnage, c'est que.
Carmen, well, the character.
Il est deux. Il est. Ce garçon fanatisé,
he's that fanaticized little boy, but some things escape him, what remains of his childhood, because he's moving from childhood into adolescence.
On a fait chaque fois attention à ce qu'il y ait des gestes
d'enfant. We were very careful. We wanted him to have the gestures of a child when he runs, for example.
Le corps d'enfant reste encore dans le corps de l'adolescent.
He's a little bit of a child, but in a teenager's body. He's clumsy, and then during the prayer scenes,
comme on dit en français, potelé, des mains d'enfant.
Are sort of a bit chubby, like when you're a child.
Thank you.
Monsieur Lamme. Welcome. Bonjour, Pierre Germet, journal Lameuse Belgique. Chaque année que vous présentez un film à Cannes, j'ai pris l'habitude d'aller jeter un coup d'œil sur la presse française. Et ce matin, j'ai lu dans Le Monde que le journaliste pensait que c'était le film le plus pessimiste de votre filmographie.
Partagez-vous cet avis. Pessimistique? That means you see everything's in a very dark, black way.
C'est qu'à un moment donné, quand le film est fini, qu'il
est fini,
une fois il est projeté devant la presse, devant le public,
been screened,
le film qu'on veut
mieux nous échappe. Whether you like it or not, the film sort of escapes us. It acquires its own life.
Avec les spectatrices, les spectateurs, les journalistes.
With the spectators, the journalists.
Je ne voudrais pas faire du commentaire de commentaire.
I don't want to comment on comments. But I will do that to a degree. It's true that to a certain extent, there is a kind of pessimism. I think it's the first time we've portrayed a character. We can't really express it in the film, but you have all these secondary characters which can't really change them. Often, in our other films, the main character changes because of certain encounters with other people.
Qui les amène à devenir autres, à changer.
They become different, they change, they open up. Here it was more complicated, it was more difficult to achieve that.
Oui, et puis comme dit Luc, on a.
And as Luc has just said.
C'est parce que, bon, voilà, on a pensé que c'est. Que cette histoire, enfin, que ce. Le fanatisme, c'est quelque chose à qui vous possède complètement.
Something that totally possesses someone.
Et que si vous voulez être à la hauteur, nous assembler, hein. Que si vous voulez être à la hauteur de.
We felt that.
De cette affaire.
In order to. Really be up to scratch.
We
couldn't have too many Romanesque elements or traits. We tried out a number of things which were too Romanesque or which didn't seem to fit in with this tremendous damage that had been wreaked. It would have been very pessimistic if he had killed Mrs. Inès or if he died, but that was not the case.
On aurait aussi peut-être pu dire que avec le personnage de Louise que joue Victoria, il y a peut-être
Louise's
une
character played by Victoria that there might have been some possibility of change. Yes, absolutely.
Mais qui ne se réalise pas. Alors ça
but
aussi.
It doesn't happen that way.
Oui, mais c'est quand même il est
but
son
still,
désir.
son désir érotique, si je puis dire.
The erotic desire, his erotic desire remains open. He discovers love thanks to Louise.
Il découvre l'amour.
Played by Victoria, he does discover love.
Et ça, c'est, first love. Je pense que le spectateur qui voit le film, en fait, c'est ce que nous espérons,
film, c'est qu'en même temps,
c'est la chute qui fait qu'il change. Mais quand même, il y a tout ce qui est précédé.
Things change at the end, but you have everything that builds up to the end that counts. You have this love story with Louise, and I think that does have its importance at the end of the film.
Merci.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Joel Mayward from Fuller Magazine, and... Sorry.
No, thank you.
I'm excited to talk to you. I'm a PhD student that's doing a doctoral research on your films. So I hope to talk to you more someday. And my question is about religion. And many audiences have seen Christian metaphors or images in your previous movies. And they've all dealt with ethics and mortality. But this is the first direct treatment of religion in your films, or at least biggest treatment of religion in your films. So I'm wondering what inspired you to finally make a movie about religion. Luke, I know that you've written about God and religion and ethics in your journals and your books. And I'm wondering, yeah, why you wanted to make a movie about religion, and what's the role of religion for you in cinema and in the public sphere? Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Beaucoup de questions, mais
that's a lot of questions
un film
rolled
sur la
into
religion,
one. A film on religion,
c'est vrai que c'est ça
true.
Que nous avons fait.
That's what we did.
Et je dirais tout de suite que le fanatisme religieux n'est pas propre à l'islam.
Is not specific to Islam. Religious fanaticism exists in the Jewish faith and in Christianism as well. As we can see in history,
I'd like
to say that the person who assassinated Isaac Rabin was a Jewish religious fanatic.
So we made a film on religion,
and here we talk about Islam because that's linked to the terrorist attacks which we've experienced since 2001.
Et ce qui nous a intéressé, c'est que bon, on a vu les films. On savait qu'il y avait des films qui avaient déjà parlé
films that had already talked about religious fanaticism, terrorism, people who leave for Syria,
la radicalisation.
Radicalization.
C'est un terme qu'on emploie en français.
That's the term that's
ça,
used
savait,
in French. In any event, we knew that.
Et on s'est dit,
heard about the economic and social reasons.
Et ça nous intéressait.
And we said to ourselves
that
nobody had taken religion seriously.
Religion, in other words, quelque chose qui est c'est un phénomène imaginaire, la religion.
Religion is an imaginary phenomenon. It's in your imagination. It's not like a glass, something physical, something tangible that actually exists.
C'est un phénomène imaginaire.
It's just a belief. So it's in one's imagination. Can one imagine that an imaginary phenomenon occupies somebody's mind in such a way that he feels authorized to kill someone else who's not like him, who is the enemy, who is the bad guy?
On a pu neutraliser ce qui était le contexte économique
et social de Ahmed. We wanted to sort of erase the economic and social context of Ahmed in order to focus on what was impure.
Pour lui, je dis bien pour lui, je ne parle pas pour l'islam.
I'm not talking about Islam, but for him.
As
he's been radicalized, his family is impure. His mother drinks alcohol. She doesn't wear the normal regulatory clothes, and so on and so forth. So that's what interested us. We wanted this young fanatic to be viewed in light of a pureness. The only pureness he finds is with his imam.
On a aussi...
And also, we imagined,
ça, on avait lu,
because this is something
pas mal de choses là-dessus,
que we'd read up on,
de jeunes ont
we read that many
idole,
young people have an idol.
Un mort qui vénère.
They have someone who's died who they worship, and in his case, it's the cousin. He worships, fanatics worship the dead, and in the name of the dead, worshiping the dead has existed in all the fascist totalitarian movements, and he has his own dead a figure whom he worships. That's why he's a bit like a zombie. It's a bit like his cousin is speaking through him and saying, go ahead and do it. His cousin is purer than the purest, so he becomes the real model. And that's what interested us. We wanted to try
de prendre cette religion au sérieux,
to
cette
take this religion really seriously.
Alors, le reste sont des questions un peu
as
trop générales.
As to the remainder,
voilà,
the questions are a bit too general. But in the case of our character, what we truly wanted to film was not the social or economic background, which would explain this and that. Otherwise, the spectator would say, oh, that's why he's become a fanatic, is because his mother or his father or his sister or their economic circumstances, he's rejected, he's poor. No. We didn't want the spectator to be taken up with those matters. The real issue is, why is this boy doing this? Why does he believe in this kind of thing? How can he go to those lengths? With Jean-Pierre, we kept saying, well, we had in mind, you may remember it.
Cet écrivain allemand, donc,
there was a German writer,
Günter Grass.
Günter Grass, Grass in his livre, last book,
his memoir, he admits that
he belonged to the SS Youth Brigade at the age of 14. He engaged right at the end of the war, so it wasn't opportunistic, and he wondered why on earth he did it. And he said, I was really taken in by this ideal of the fatherland that needed to be defended.
On s'est dit, notre personnage, il est
we thought,
séduit,
well, our
religion,
character is totally attracted and taken in by this idea. And that's what ideologies do. They attract people and then completely take them in.
Peter Paul Hout, Télévision Un Monde, ZTF, 3SAT. Je voulais continuer dans cette dans votre réponse.
To follow on your answer.
Dans le film, pourquoi
in
il
the
devient
film, one wonders why he becomes a fanatic.
Déjà au début,
at the
la mère dit, mais
he is to a degree, and the mother
semaines, tu as toujours
says,
occupé avec
well, you're always
vidéo.
Busy with
pourquoi
the video games. Why does he
aussi,
become fanatic subsequently? Could you perhaps give us
purité?
More details about this idea of pureness, being pure? I had the impression that this idea of being pure is what runs through the entire film and holds it together. Well, it's not that I don't want to answer your question.
Quand le film commence,
when the film begins, the boy
is fanatic. Et on n'a pas essayé d'expliquer pourquoi.
At the beginning, the boy is already a fanatic.
On pourrait dire
we don't really know why. What we can say.
Il est à un âge.
Is that he's at an age.
Ahmed est à un âge où
Ahmed is at an age
où on quitte un peu la famille, où on commence à avoir des repères un peu en dehors de la famille, que la famille ne contrôle pas nécessairement.
The family doesn't necessarily control you any longer, and he met the wrong people. He met this imam.
À un moment
who turned up in his life at a time when he was looking for other yardsticks in life, for something else in life, which he couldn't find in his family. So it was fertile ground. He was at an age where the idea of pureness, purity, could develop very easily and grow.
Ce qu'on appelle l'idéal.
It was a question of an ideal. He was at an age when ideals are absolute values which can really mobilize you. And he met the imam at that time who mobilized this aspiration, this desire and quest for an ideal, for this idea of being pure.
Qui va jusqu'au fait où il refuse d'embrasser sa mère.
To such an extent that he refuses to kiss or hug his mother. The imam turned up in his life, and
les purs et les impurs.
The world is divided between the pure and the impure.
Tous les films fonctionnent là-dessus.
And that's how the film works. And that's how all the action works. You have this character that we created, and he sets himself these limits. He has to protect himself all the time from what's not pure.
Et c'est cet idéal, c'est ce que, par exemple, un psychanalyste qu'on a rencontré quand on a préparé le film,
a psychoanalyst we met when we prepared the film, that's what he calls
the
sort of a super Muslim ego. He said, when we talked about this, no, these aren't real Muslims. It's this idea of absolute purity. You can never be sufficiently pure. It can only lead to death and the elimination of all those who are not sufficiently pure. And like what you were saying, the only real pureness you can find is in death. this kind of ideal leads you into
bonjour,
death.
Bonjour, Monsieur Dardenne. Good morning. Portugal,
I come from Portugal. I'll be speaking French as best I can.
Je voudrais savoir I would like l'origine de vos projets et aussi comment
know about the roots of this film.
Thème.
You both worked on the same theme. You're of a single mind.
Je me demande si ça, c'était aussi une question, disons, la séduction dès la radicalisation et aussi la séduction.
Been talking about radicalization, how this can take someone in, and the seduction of love as well.
Ahmed, s'il now I peut turn comprendre to young cette, Ahmed.
Do you understand?
Les personnes de leur âge, cette espèce de séduction.
How someone that age can be totally taken in by these ideas.
Moi, je suis pas.
Non. Par Ahmed, par
I don't know.
Dans la vraie vie.
Non, dans le film. Tu veux en parler ou pas?
Je veux pas.
No, I don't really feel like answering that. It's very difficult. He's very young. Particularly when he was shooting, we were shooting the film. So you were saying, what were you saying exactly?
La séduction.
Ah, you were referring to seduction being taken in.
Jean-Pierre just talked about that. When you're an adolescent, the
model of the family is no longer there. You're looking for some different model, either in hatred or in love, for example.
Un idéal humanitaire, un idéal de partage, de générosité.
Your ideal could be sharing generosity. He could have met someone who would have led him into such humanitarian areas, but he meets someone who actually imprisons him. Closes him in. Unfortunately, hatred can also be an ideal. Very destructive ideal. He feels that he's growing up. He views something that is greater than himself. He feels happy, even in terms of his brother. The imam says to him, you'll see you later on, your brother will be pious like you. And he says, yes, but my brother's always afraid, even in terms of his brother. The imam plays with this rivalry, and that's how he manages to totally take him in.
J'ai déjà répondu pourquoi on a pensé à ce personnage.
Told you why we thought about the character.
Tous les attentats que nous avons connus.
Because of all the terrorist attacks that have taken place in Europe, in the United States, in Sri Lanka, in the Middle East.
Madame a parlé tout à l'heure très bien.
As mentioned earlier on.
Elle connaissait les choses aussi. Donc c'est pas seulement en Europe.
It's not just in Europe that these terrorist attacks have occurred. And that's the overall context that led us to make this film.
Il y avait une deuxième question qui était posée par monsieur.
Question.
Essayez de demander aux acteurs qui sont ici à cette table, qui n'ont pas encore beaucoup parlé, leur avis. Comment est-ce que Jean-Pierre et Luc vous ont dirigé? Comment est-ce qu'on s'adresse à deux personnes à la fois ou à tour de rôle?
Relate to both at the same time, or is it one after the other?
Perhaps
I'll turn first to those who've already been in a Dardenne Brother films, and then we'll talk about the newcomers. How did you prepare the characters together?
On va commencer par vous, si vous,
with you, if you like.
J'avais tourné encore avec. Oui. J'avais jamais tourné, donc.
This is my first film, in fact, with the Dardenne Brothers. So let's start with those who've been in a lot of their films.
Myriam.
Comment est-ce qu'on travaille avec deux personnes
en même temps? Moi, j'ai
le sentiment en tournant avec les frères, j'ai l'impression plus efficace.
I have the impression that that's perhaps more efficient.
Olivier, vous avez démarré avec un rôle très important dans le.
You had a very important part in the preceding.
Comment est-ce que vous avez préparé?
Dardenne Brother film. How did you prepare this part?
Alors la préparation, il y a eu un temps de répétition.
Well, there were rehearsals.
On a eu accès, on a pu voir un décor qui est un vrai centre fermé. Hein,
We were on the set, which is truly an enclosed center.
Les éducateurs qui travaillent dans ce centre fermé.
There were educators working there. And I was able to talk with them,
and
I watched them while they were doing their work.
Qui se sont occupés de jeunes qui étaient radicalisés.
Some of them were working with young radicalized children. So I was able to see what really happens in real life, and that helped me no end. And what did the rehearsals consist in? Learning the lines by heart, or it was on the spot, on the set? Yes, everything took place on the spot with Jean-Pierre and Luc, and there were all the actors concerned by this or that scene.
C'est plus que du défrichage, c'est
and it was more than just sort of going through things for the first time, doing the rough stuff. No, on the contrary.
Alors maintenant, les nouveaux venus, excusez-moi.
Now, what about the newcomers?
Moi, j'ai trouvé d'abord, c'était une rencontre humaine,
first
déjà.
Of all,
et ensuite, le travail avec les frères, c'est que c'est un échange. L'air de ne pas être touché, ils écoutent.
A kind of permanent exchange when you work with the brothers.
Les petits commentaires qu'on donne sur les répétitions, parce qu'il y a
we also make comments during the rehearsals, they listen carefully, and also they shoot chronologically.
C'est ça, en cinéma, en fait, de tourner dans la continuité.
They shoot chronologically.
C'est un luxe.
And that's quite a luxury, in fact. That's something that's hardly ever done now. For an actor, it's very worthwhile.
Quand la plupart ici viennent du théâtre,
most people here come from the theater, and we had very long sequences,
very long shoots. Auquel on est rompu, on a l'habitude de ça, puisqu'on est amené à jouer de longues parties quand on est au théâtre. Il y a quelque chose de très réaliste et en même temps très calculé, très pesé.
There's something very, very realistic, yet extremely calculated at the same time. Nothing is left to chance. Everything is very precise and everything is constantly questioned. During the rehearsals and even when shooting on the set, they take time and say, no, that doesn't work, let's stop, let's think about the matter again. They give everyone time, let's not rush into things.
Est-ce que vous aviez conscience que dans le personnage que vous interprétiez, il y avait des dangers en tant qu'acteur?
Or traps for the actor?
De ma communauté, en tout cas, oui. En
yes,
jouant le rôle d'un imam.
Of course, I played the part of an imam.
Tout séducteur et pas très bienveillant. Oui, oui.
Not very kind and who takes a hold of people. Yes, I expect to get a lot of feedback from my community.
Comment s'est passé?
What about what was it like for you, Victoria, living in such an enclosed area? Things are very precise when working with the brothers.
Honnêtement, j'avais jamais été pousser un veau ou lui donner du lait ou faire des choses comme ça. Donc après les répétitions,
well, when it came to the rehearsals, as Olivier was saying, we were really on the spot. And then Jacques was there. He was the real farmer in the farm, and he taught us the various gestures. And he said, no, it's more like this or more like that. Be careful. Very technical hints and helping comments, so things would look realistic, as though I was a real farmer myself. Of course, during these rehearsals, what was important was to ensure that all these gestures became really believable. We had to get used to doing these things. We're not usually accustomed to it in our life, but we learned all this through the rehearsals so that things looked really natural and realistic. You did things automatically, therefore, without thinking about them, thanks to all the rehearsals. Yes, we would say, okay, we're going to rehearse, we're going to shoot this scene, we're going to do this or that, and we were able to do it very naturally, thanks to the rehearsing. There are a lot of very specific gestures in your character.
J'ai beaucoup fait d'ablutions.
Yes, the ablutions.
J'ai beaucoup prié aussi.
I prayed a lot too.
Mais en ce qui concerne ma relation avec
when it came to my relationship with the brothers, we had a very good relationship, and as Miriam was saying, for me it was wonderful being in their film. It's as though there's just one more person, one person, one who acts and one who thinks.
C'est assez amusant parce que
it's quite amusing, actually.
Quand parfois ils sont pas d'accord sur quelque chose,
sometimes when they don't agree on something, they speak together. And when you look at them, it's always very, very funny when you watch.
Il va tout dévoiler.
He's going to tell you all.
Juste comme
Claire, et Claire.
Oui.
And Claire.
J'ai envie de dire que la réponse est complète.
Well, I think you've gotten a very comprehensive answer.
Ce qui a été
What I might add is that for me and for all of us, what was really, really pleasant is that they have this rare combination of kindness and frankness. Things are immediately clear.
Ils ont la délicatesse quand effectivement ils ont quelque chose à se dire.
When they have something to say to the actor, they ask other people in the group to sort of stand back and they just address that specific person who they want to talk to. After the takes, it's always very good. Jean-Pierre really indulges more in gestures and Luc more in speaking. I'm not going to give everything away, of course. Perhaps the others would like to talk about the takes.
On peut balancer?
Oui.
Well, maybe we can give them away.
Moi, c'est 39.
Avec Claire. Le maximum,
c'était quoi? C'est pas nous, c'est pas
le maximum historique
du. The historic maximum.
Non, mais ça dépend des plans. Parfois, quand c'est un long plan séquence, ça dépend de beaucoup de choses. Il y a des voitures qui doivent passer derrière.
A lot of things. If there are cars driving past.
Quand vous dites franchise, qu'est-ce que vous avez un exemple?
Do you have an example of that?
Franchise, en tout cas.
Well, frankness, in terms of being very clear.
On se dit. Non, c'est. Bien sûr, il y a eu les répétitions.
Obviously, we rehearsed a lot.
Très vite, ce qu'ils ne veulent pas.
One immediately senses what they don't want. You sense what they do want, and then there's something mysterious in the middle. And after each take, it's just clear. It's crystal clear.
Et je pense que c'est pas évident.
That it's not easy to achieve that kind of thing without stressing people.
Gentiment, nous, t'étais. T'étais pas bien. Okay, et c'est pas grave. Et voilà.
It does not really matter. A few gestures.
Oui, c'est ça, c'est une clarté.
Something clear. There is some clarity. Everything flows in the communication.
Qui accompagne les frères Dardenne depuis beaucoup de films déjà.
A question for Dennis Fred, who's been the producer of the Dardenne brothers for a certain number of years.
Soit dans le montage.
Which problems may you have encountered in this particular project?
Oui, effectivement, j'accompagne les frères depuis.
Right, I've been working with the Dardenne brothers for the last seven feature films, working with Thompson also.
À la production. Non, je dirais en termes d'organisation, il n'y a pas eu de particularité.
There was no particular problem in this project.
Le sujet du film, parce que
the new feature was the subject, the theme of the film. The Dardenne brothers always tackled universal themes, but this particular project is quite different for historical reasons. Everyone, according to one's own culture or ideas, has a certain point of view on what happens in present-day society. What can we tell about this in an hour and a half? So these questions were dealt with starting with the script. So we're almost at the end of the press conference. There is one last question.
Bonjour, Monsieur Hayashi, le journal quotidien japonais.
Hello, I'm from Japan.
Cinéaste.
A question for both directors.
Il y a quelques jours, je crois que des groupes de cinéastes et producteurs et acteurs.
A few days ago, there's a group of directors and actors who published an article in Le Monde, the French daily, to underline the primordial role of the French cultural exception, culture exception. And you signed that article also. Would you say a few words on this? Why have you signed this article?
Parce que comme tous les cinéastes, nous sommes persuadés.
We are directors, and like every director, we feel that the French cultural exception makes it possible for the cinema in Europe to continue in its diversity.
Et nous avons voulu tous les cinéastes qui ont signé, and pas seulement les cinéastes, c'est-à-dire aussi les.
We wanted, along with our filmmaker colleagues and actors, underline the importance of this and our desire for the French exception to continue. Should it be threatened, the models of European film production and part of the world also would be at stake. This would be a great flaw in present-day society. Behind your question, the question of the French exception is the role of the state, of the public services. This is what we should be defending in the forthcoming European Parliament elections. Without the role of the state, cinema in different countries would not exist. Thanks to governments, thanks to Europe, the cinema still exists.
Dans les pays d'Europe où l'État n'a pas la capacité ou ne veut pas.
In a few European countries, the state does not invest in filmmaking. I will not give a list of those countries, but there are a few European countries where it is extremely difficult to shoot films. Without France, things would be hard. Thank you.
Bravo.